so patiently. You waited for me, just for me. You waited for me, just for me. Be if it's not me go, where will I be if you let me go? Where will I be if you let me down? If you let me, if you let me, I wanna know where will I be if you let me. Where will I be if you let me? Where will I be if you let me? Waited, oh Lord, you me. Where will I be if you let me? Where will I be, Lord, if you let me go? Where will I be, Lord, if you let me down? Where will I be, Lord, if you let me down? Where will I be, Lord, if you let me down? Sing grace, show so patiently. You show so patiently. You waited for me, just for me. You waited for me, just for me.
Blessings, blessings. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Blessings to you all in the name of God the Father. Blessing to you all in the name of God the Son. Blessing to you all, blessing to you all. God bless you. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for tuning in. As you come in, can you just go ahead and share the video, please? So that other people can know that we are live. Can you go ahead and share the video? Richmond Igbe, sweetheart, I see you. Passing Dawn, sweetheart, I see you. Leo Sunday, sweetheart, I see you. God bless you. Just share the video so that other people can see that we are live and we are gonna start in any moment. Go ahead and share the video. God bless you. So that people can see that we are live and come on. God bless you. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Good morning, God bless you. Good evening, good morning, good evening. God bless you wherever you're watching from. Please go ahead and share the video so that other people can see that we are live. Go ahead and share the video. God bless you. Again to my family, oh, I swear I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm surrounded by the arms of the Father. I'm surrounded. To freedom, Lord. God bless you. If you can just go ahead and share the video so that other people can see that we are on. Cletus, God bless you. Utibe, God bless you. Richmond, God bless you. Thank you for tuning in. Just go ahead and share the video.
I am a child of God, a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. God bless us real good. God bless us real good. Thank you for tuning in. It's about quarter to 11 here in Canada. And I just came on to share the word. So I just want you to go ahead and share this video so that other people can see that we are online and they could join us. So I talked to this video. I want to preach. I'm coming to bring the word of God our way. And on the video, I have talked the video, the power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus. Most often, people do not understand what is the power. If somebody asks you a question, a little child comes to you and says, please, auntie, uncle, what is the power in the blood of Jesus? What is the power in the blood of Jesus? That is what we are going to learn today. Okay, before we start, we are quickly going to pray. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, we worship you, we honor you because you're God. We adore you because there is none like you. We give you the glory, we give you the honor at this moment. We bless your name for who you are. We reference you because you're God forever. Lord Jesus, as I'm bringing the word to your children's way, to your children's direction, I pray that the blood will speak, that the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel will begin to speak better things in our lives, that the blood of Jesus that healed the sick, that touched people, will begin to work wonders in our life. Father, as we hear the word, we are praying that you would help us to apply this word, that you will help us to use the word, that you will help us to key into the word so that the word can work wonders in our life. Let us not just hear the word. Let us not just listen. Let us not just view. Give us the grace, Lord, to be able to apply the word so that it can work wonders in our life. This and all other prayer we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you once again for tuning in. If it is your first time for you viewing me, you can go to my page and look more. My name is Kate Favor Omorin. I'm a born-again Christian. And by the grace of God, God has been using me and he has been touching lives. He has been doing wonderful things. As we fellowship together in love and in unity, God will meet us all at the point of our needs. So today, without taking much time, the topic for the sermon is the blood, the power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus. Now, the question is, what is in the blood that heals? Why is it that when we call the blood of Jesus, we are free? When we call the blood of Jesus, we are rescued. When we call the blood of Jesus, things begin to happen for us. When we call the blood of Jesus, miracle happens. When we call the blood of Jesus, cancer disappears. Why? What is in the blood? What is in the blood that heals? What is in that blood that heals? What is it that is in the blood that heals? That is what we are going to be speaking about. That thing that is in the blood that heals. I just want to keep my things that I jot down so that everyone can hear me very well. What is in the blood that heals? So today we'll be taking our first anchor scripture from Exodus chapter 12, verses 23. If you have your Bible, can you just quickly open to the book of Exodus chapter 12, verses 23, because we are coming to read.
Exodus 12, chapter 23. Hopefully I can see and read. It says, my light is not very good. So Exodus 12, 23 says, "For the Lord will pass through the land to strike down the Egyptian." For the Lord will pass through the land to strike the Egyptians. For the Lord will pass through the land to strike down the Egyptian, but when he sees the blood on top, when he sees the blood on top and by the side of their door frames, he will pass over them. My light is not really giving me what I want. But the Lord will pass through the land to strike down the Egyptians, and when he sees the blood in the top or in the side, he will pass over. He will pass over them. When he sees the blood, he will pass over them. He will pass over them. When he sees the blood on their door frame, the Lord will pass over your home. He will not permit the dead angels to enter your homes and strike you down. That is what the Bible says in Exodus 12:23. The blood of Jesus can do marvelous things. That even when the enemy passes through your doorstep and sees the blood of Jesus, he cannot strike. He cannot strike. No evil is permitted to come near you. No evil is permitted to come near me. Why? Because the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel is what we have. Therefore, no sickness, nothing can come near our dwelling place. Because for the Lord will pass through the land to strike down the Egyptian, but when he sees the blood on top and by the side of the door frame, the Lord will pass over your home. He will not permit the dead angels to enter your house and strike you down. What are the dead angels? The dead angels are the enemies that are fighting. The dead angels are the sickness. The dead angels are evil people. The dead angels are people that are fighting against us, people that don't want us to go forward. Those are the dead enemies. And when you have the blood of Jesus, when the dead enemy comes, the Bible speaking says the blood on top or by the side of your door frames will not allow the evil angels, the dead angels, to strike you down. So no evil. For what the scripture has said in Exodus 12:23 has given us hope, has given us faith, has strengthened us this morning, this moment, that no evil is permitted to come near us. No evil whatsoever is permitted to come near us. Why? Because when they come, they will see the blood of Jesus by our door frame, and the dead angels will not be able to come in and strike us down. According to Exodus 12:23. So we're going to be taking another scripture, and that will be Revelation chapter 12, verses 11. Revelation 12, 11. If you have your Bible, you can read with me. Open to the book of Revelation chapter 11. "And they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb." And they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. And they did not live their lives so much in that they were afraid to die. Some of us, we are living our life in a way that we are so afraid to die. We are living our lives in a way that we are so afraid to die. Like, we are so very
so, so very afraid to die. And now the Bible is telling us in Revelation 12, verses 11, and they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony, and they were not afraid. They were not living so much that they were afraid to die. Child of God, you do not need to live your life as if you are afraid to die. Why? The blood that heals is a rescue power. Even when you get into an accident, the blood of Jesus will rescue you. Even when you are sick, the blood of Jesus will rescue you. Even when you are down, the blood of Jesus will rescue you. This is the power in the blood to restore you, to rescue you, to bring you back, to exalt you, to elevate you, to fill you up, to satisfy you. So when you are down to nothing, remember that they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony. They did not love their lives so much that they were afraid to die. So today, you are not going to love your life so much that you are afraid to die. The reason we are afraid to die is because we are not ready. The reason we are afraid of death is because we have not prepared our path. The reason we are afraid of death is because we have not made it right with God. But trust me, when you make it right with God, when you leave this earth, there is another life for you, a better life, a safe place. But when you are not ready, you are so afraid to die. Some people might not even want to go to bed so that they will not sleep off. Some people, when they are sick, they just feel that it's going to end for them. No. You can hear in the scripture. It says, and they did not love their life so much that they were afraid to die. Don't love your life so much that you are afraid to die. Because the blood of Jesus, the power in the blood, will protect you from all evils. The power in the blood will guide you from every accident. The power in the blood will rescue you from every incident. The power in the blood of Jesus will resurrect you when you are down. The power in the blood of Jesus will give to you that which you're looking for. The power in the blood of Jesus will make you rest in eternity even when you are gone. Blessings, people of God. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you real good. God bless you real good. So, the power in the blood of Jesus has a rescue power. The power in the blood of Jesus has a rescue power to rescue you from death, to rescue you from depression, to rescue you from cancer, to rescue you from diabetes, to rescue you from every manner of disease. To rescue you from childlessness, to rescue you from poverty, to rescue you from recklessness, to rescue you from womanizing, to rescue you from flirting, to rescue you from homosexual. The blood of Jesus has that rescue power to rescue you from whatever you're going through in your life. Physically, socially, emotionally, the power in the blood of Jesus has the rescue power to do all of that for you. All you need do is just acknowledge the power in the blood of Jesus, and you are good. Okay, now we are going to be taking another scripture, Hezekiah 9 verses 11. Hezekiah 9 verses 11. Hezekiah 9 verses 11. My light is not good. Because of the covenant I made with you, sealed with blood, I will free your prisoners. Because of the covenant I made with you with blood, I would free your prisoners from both of the world being set. Did you hear that? Because of the covenant, that means that God even made a covenant with us. God made a covenant with us. And he's saying now in Ezekiel chapter 9 verses 11 that because of the covenant that he made with us with blood. God is wonderful. Praise the Lord. Somebody, you did not hear that. You did not just hear what I read now. You did not hear what I read. The Bible says, because of the covenant I made with you, sealed with blood, I will free your prisoners from death in a waterless dungeon. What is a dungeon? The Bible says, I will free your prisoners from death in a waterless dungeon. A dungeon is a cell, a deep pit, a chain, a center, something that is held. That's what a dragon is. God says, because of the covenant I made with you, sealed with blood, I will free your prisoners from death in a waterless dungeon, where there is no opening, where there is no space, where there is no way. God says he will free your prisoners. So I am reading from Ezekiel chapter 9 verses 11, and I'm going to read that again. Because of the covenant I made with you, sealed with blood, I will free your prisoners from death in a waterless dungeon. So, you are too defended to be attacked by the devil. You are too defended. You are too filled. You are too grace. You are too powerful. You are too anointed to be defeated by the devil. You cannot be defeated. You cannot be. You are too defended to be attacked by the devil. God has so offended. God has so defended you. You are too defended. You are too loaded. You are so grace-filled. You carry anointing that the devil cannot attack you. But because you do not know the power in the blood of Jesus, that is why the devil play mind game with some people. Because they do not know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you are too defended for the devil to attack. You are too grace-filled for the devil to use. You are too powerful for the evil, for the enemy to triumph. When you begin to use the rescue power in the blood of Jesus, you would see that so many things will begin to fall in place for you. You shall no more be fearful. You shall no more be disturbed. You shall no more be worried. Why? You have heard in Ezekiel that you are too defended to be attacked by the devil. When you carry the blood, the power in the blood of Jesus, the devil cannot touch you. The devil cannot come near your dwelling place. Why? Because you carry power. Why? Because you carry anointing. Why? Because you carry grace. Why? Because you are Holy Ghost filled. The devil cannot attack you. When you know the power in the blood of Jesus, the devil cannot touch you. The devil cannot attack you. The devil cannot come near your dwelling place. He's afraid. He can't do anything. Okay, so now we are going to be reading another scripture. Matthew chapter 27 from verses 50 to 52. Hope that my light will allow us to go through these portions. Matthew 27, Matthew 27, 50 to 52. My light is not very good, but I'll manage to read. Then Jesus shouted out again. Then Jesus shouted out again, and he rescued. I'm gonna try to get a different light so that I can read. I think I need glasses now. So what we are talking about is the power that is in the blood. The power that is in the blood of Jesus is grave-shattering power. Is sickness-scattering power. Is depression-scattering power. When you know the power that is in the blood, the devil cannot do anything. The devil cannot come near your dwelling place. The devil is afraid of you. He cannot. So, then Jesus shouted out again and he released his spirit in that moment, and the curtains in the sanctuary of the temple was torn in two from up to the bottom, and the earth from up to the bottom. Please just try and take down this scripture and read it for yourself. Okay. Down, what I'm reading now is Matthew chapter 27 from verses 50 to 52. Matthew 27, 50 to 52. So the power that is in the blood of Jesus is too powerful. It's too powerful. It's grace shattering power. It's grave. You know, when Jesus was in the grave, the soldiers were there guiding it. But by the time he wanted to resurrect, they did not even know how the stone was moved, how the stone was pulled. But the Bible makes us to understand that they were asleep and he resurrected and he went. That is the power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus is grave shattering. God can scatter the grave and bring you out from your grave, just like he did and brought Lazarus back to life. After how many days? How many days was Lazarus dead? He brought him back. People were saying that Lazarus has maggots has gotten into Lazarus, but that was not the concern of God. Why? Jesus carries the blood, the power in his own blood. So now he says that great and mighty things shall we do, even more than he did. So when you know the power, when you know the power in the blood of Jesus, you can even do more powerful things that God did. He said the temple was torn in two from the top to bottom. The earth shook. The earth shook, rocks split apart, and tombs opened. The bodies of many godly men and women who had died raised from the dead. Can you imagine what the shattering power of God can do? He says, then Jesus shouted out again, and he released the spirit. And at that moment, the setting in the sanctuary temple was torn into two. Oh, praise God. God is awesome. God is worthy. The temple was torn into two from the top to the bottom. The earth shook. The rock split. The tombs open, the graves were open, and the bodies of godly men and women who had died were raised from death. Godly men and godly women who had died rose from death. Why? Because of the power in the blood of Jesus. The power in the blood of Jesus is grave shattering. God can shatter the grave and bring back godly men and women back to life. May the power in the blood of Jesus bring back whoever is loose, whoever is lost, whoever is suffering, whoever is sick, whoever is not going well with him or her in the spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Another scripture that we are going to be taking is going to be Hosea. My light is not good for me to read for you. So you probably might just have to take some of the scripture and read it for yourself. So I'm going to be reading Hosea. Hosea chapter 13 verses 14. Should I ransom them from the grave? This is Jesus asking a question. Should I ransom them from the grave? Should I redeem them from death? O death, bring on your terrors. O grave, bring on your plagues, for I will take pity on them. Can you imagine? What are promises of God? God's last card for rescue. This is God's last card for rescue. 1 John 5 verses 8. Hopefully the light will permit me to read. First John, let's see what the scripture says in 1 John. 1 John chapter 5 verses 8. 1 John 5 verses 8. It says, the spirit, the water, and the blood, and all three agreed. When you have the power of God, when you have the power in the blood of Jesus, when you have that power that is in the blood of Jesus, the Bible is speaking in John, 1 John chapter 5 verses 8, that the spirit, the water, and the blood will all agree. All three will agree. Even when you are dead, the power, the spirit, the water, the blood, all three will agree, and you will resurrect back to life. Like the promises that God has given to us. Why? Because you know the power in the blood of Jesus. Because you know the power in the blood of Jesus. That the blood of Jesus is the only blood that speaketh better things. That the blood of Jesus is the only blood that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. If the blood of Abel could speak, what do you think about the blood of Jesus? The blood of Jesus can speak into your sickness. The blood of Jesus can speak into your marriage. The blood of Jesus can speak into that sickness, into that disease, into that infirmity, into that bad situation, into that ugly circumstances. The blood of Jesus can speak into it and begin to give life to you if you don't have life, and begin to give hope to you if you don't have hope, and begin to give trust, patience, everything that you need. The blood of Jesus can begin to give you a salvation. When you have the blood of Jesus, when you know the power in the blood of Jesus, all three shall agree. Like the Bible says in 1 John chapter 5 verses 8, the spirit, the water, the blood, and all three agrees. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. You can take your hands and put it on your forehead and say, you headache, I command you now to let loose in the blood of Jesus. By the power that is in the blood of Jesus, I pray for my daughter to receive healing right now. And it comes to pass. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you carry that resume, you carry that CV, you walk into an office, you sit in your house, you begin to speak what you want to say. You begin to speak what you want to say. Before you go and apply for that job, the blood of Jesus had already gone before you, because you know the power that is in the blood, that you can command things when you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. You will begin to command your day. You will begin to command your health. You will begin to command your prosperity. You will begin to command your marriage. You will begin to command your relationship. You will begin to command healing. You will begin to command divine health. Why? Because you know the power that is in the power of the blood of Jesus. It is the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. It is the blood of Jesus that giveth power. It is the blood of Jesus that giveth strength. It is the power that is in the blood of Jesus that can command everything to come back. For us, it is the power that is in the blood. The power that is in the blood of Jesus is the only thing that can cause things to happen, cause people to favor you, cause people to bless you. The power that is in the blood brings healing to you, brings happiness, brings contentment, brings peace of mind, brings wealth. What is it? There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus that will speak better things that you cannot just imagine. That will speak better things in a way that you cannot just imagine. You did not think of it. You were not expectant. But because you know the power in the blood of Jesus, you begin to command things and then you begin to see it happen. You begin to see it happen. You don't run helter-skelter when you are in need. You don't run helter-skelter when there is a problem. You don't run helter-skelter when you are sick. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood, that you can stand and you can begin to command and say, right now, I speak into my body. I want to receive healing. Right now, I speak into my body. I want to be healed. Right now, I speak into my body. I want to receive power. Right now, I speak into my word. I want this situation to move. I want this situation to move. When you know the power that is in the blood, you begin to command things. You begin to walk without fear. You begin to command your day. People begin to see the power of God in your life. People begin to see you have testimony. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. If you don't know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, the devil uses you. The devil laughs. The devil laughs. The devil laughs. Why? Because he knows deep inside him, I can use this one. I can use this one. I can do as I like with this one. Why? Because he knows that you do not know the power that is in the blood of Jesus for you to stand and begin to speak, for you to stand and begin to command, for you to stand and begin to control, for you to stand and take charge, for you to stand and dominate, for you to stand and seal over. That is the power that is in the blood of Jesus. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you are not afraid of darkness. Let me tell you a story. Before I gave my life to Jesus, I used to be very fearful. I cannot sleep in the room alone. It is either I will turn on the light, even with the light turned on, I'm still afraid. Like, I need to hold my siblings on the bed. I just take all of their pajamas, their nightwear, whatever. I hold it so that if they try to stand up, I would know that they are getting up. That is how fearful I was. Where does fear come from? Fear comes from the devil to destroy you, to neutralize what God has put in you, to bring you down, to triumph upon you. So you got to use the breakthrough power that is in the blood of Jesus. You got to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus. The Bible speaking says, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. You got to begin to make use of the blood. You got to begin to speak the blood. You got to begin to command the blood. You got to begin to call the blood. You got to begin to sprinkle the word. You got to begin to use the blood as your daily medication. Every morning you get up, you say, Lord, I stand in the power that is in the blood of Jesus, and I command this day that this day shall be my best day ever in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless us. God bless you, David. God bless you, David. So, we just read 1 John. Now, we are going to be reading, hopefully I can see. Now, we're going to be reading Hebrews. Now we're going to be reading from the book of Hebrews. Just take it down. Just take it down, please, so that we save time. So we are going to read Hebrews 12, Hebrews chapter 12, verses 22 to 24. Please take down the note so that you can read. Understanding my right to good health and healing through the blood of Jesus. Understanding my right, understanding your right to healing and good health through Christ. Okay, please write that so that you can read it. You can read it, okay? Hebrews 12, chapter 22 to 24. Please study it, revise it, please. Please revise it. And then we are also going to be reading from Matthew. Going to be reading Matthew. Write down Matthew. Matthew 27. You can read all of that and see what was happening when the people believe in the power that is in the blood of Jesus. When you believe in the power that is in the blood of Jesus, sickness no longer knows you. Poverty no longer knows you. The devil no longer knows you. Evil people no longer knows you. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, and you begin to call on the power. You begin to speak on the power. You begin to speak the word. You begin to pronounce the word. You begin to declare the word. You begin to dominate. You begin to, oh my goodness. Somebody, you're not hearing me. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, everything turns around for you. May the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel speak better things for us today in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, so another one is going to be another Bible verse that we're going to be reading. You can write it down and read it. Ecclesiastes 10:7. Ecclesiastes 10:7. Okay, I can just read that one. I have even seen servants riding horseback like princes and princesses, waiting like servants. When I read this Bible portion, I cried. Because people do not know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Because you don't know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Listen to what the scripture says. The scripture says, I have even seen servants riding horseback like princes and princesses, walking like servants. God have mercy on us. We have God. We are walking like an elephant, and we are eating like ants. Why? Because we cannot command the power that is in the blood of Jesus. We cannot command it. Then we begin to suffer like the princesses. You see how you are a prince. God has made us prince. God has made us prince and princesses. God has made us queens. God has made us angels. But because we do not know our stand, because we do not know our place, because we cannot come to God and begin to read our scripture and begin to know what is it that God requires from us, what is it that God wants from us, what is it that we should do to align our lives with the power that is in the blood of Jesus, we begin to eat like ants. We begin to ride. We begin to be seen as servants, riding us back like princes and princesses, walking like servants. How can we be called of God if we are walking like servants? We go to places, especially for those of us abroad, you will see children of God doing cleaning jobs, walking like servants, but they have a degree, they have a certificate, they have gone to school. But they cannot. Why? Because they have refused to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus. And begin to pray and command their day and say to God, Lord Jesus, I cannot. I have seen in the scripture today, you have used your daughter to tell me that I cannot be a prince, I cannot be a princess and be eating like an ant and be living like a servant. Father, I want you to elevate me. Father, I want you to raise me. Father, I want you to anoint me. Father, I want you to lift me. Father, I want you to uplift me. Father, I want you to showcase me. It is God that showcases people. May the good Lord showcase us that we will no longer eat like ants. May the good Lord showcase us that we will no longer walk like slaves. May the good Lord elevate us after this sermon, that we will begin to know our rights as children of God and take our inheritance and stand and declare and hear what God has for us. So finally, I'm going to be reading from Psalms 105, verses 37. The Bible says, "The Lord brought the people out of Egypt." The Lord brought his people out of Egypt. The Lord brought his people. The Lord brought his people out of Egypt, loaded with silver and gold. There's an incoming call coming into my phone. The Lord brought the people out of Egypt and loaded with silver, and loaded with silver and gold, and how? And loaded with silver and gold, and not among the tribe of Israel, even stumble. Can you imagine? Can you imagine the scripture? Can you imagine the scripture? So when you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, the Lord will bring you out like he brought the Israelites, and nobody would stumble. Nobody would ask. Nobody would say anything. Why? Because God has brought you out of Israel. God has brought you out of poverty. God has brought you out of sickness. God has brought you out of your low place. God has brought you from where you did not believe. God has brought you from where you did not think. God has brought you from where you did not expect. God has brought you from where you were not even expecting. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, things will begin to happen for you. Your work will fall in place. Your life will fall in place. Your marriage will fall in place. Your relationship will fall in place. Everything that you do will fall in place. Why? You know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, and you are using it, and you are commanding it, and you are saying it. You got to know the power that is in the blood of Jesus to be able to use it, to be able to claim it, to be able to possess it, to be able to take everything that you want. The power that is in the blood of Jesus. Now we are going to listen to this song. We're going to listen to this song, and then we can now go. So, that's the power that is in the blood of Jesus. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will never be sick again. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will be rescued. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will be too defended for the devil to attack. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, the power that is in the blood of Jesus is grave-shattering power. The power that is in the blood of Jesus is a power that can heal. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, understand your right to good health and healing is sure. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, every chain in your life will be broken. Every chain in your life will be loose. Every poverty in your life will be set free. Every delay in your life will be brought to pass immediately. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Listen to this song and be blessed. Listen to this song and be blessed. Listen to this song and be blessed. In the name of Jesus. To break every chain. 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 Please key in and sing in the spirit. Just key in and begin to sing. There is power in the blood of Jesus. Sing up. There is an army rising up.
There is an army rising up. There is an army rising up.
to break every chain, break every chain, to break every chain. Every chain is breaking in your life right now. Every chain of sorrows, every chain of sickness, every chain of poverty, every chain of lamentation, every chain of womanizing, every friend of disease, every chain of diarrhea, every sense of diabetes, every chain of cancer, every chain of depression, every friend of every chain of lacking, every chain of setback, every chain of delay is breaking right now in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. As you have heard, the blood through power that can do wonders, that can touch life, that can heal you. Everything, every chain is breaking that right now in your life. Every chain of poverty, every chain of sickness, every chain of anything that you're going through is breaking forth. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Every chain is breaking loose right now because you know the power that is in the breakthrough of Jesus. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, sickness will no longer know you. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, the devil is not permitted to come near your dwelling place. I hear the chain falling. The songwriter says, I hear the chain falling. Every chain of sickness, every chain of poverty, every chain of disease, every chain of infirmity, every chain that was not put from God is falling right now. And so shall it be forever in the mighty name of Jesus. It was a wonderful moment. It was a wonderful moment. I want you to use the blood. I want you to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus and heal yourself and command your day and command your blessings and command your children and command everything that is not working in your life. That joblessness, that lack of job, that lack of peace. I want you to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus and begin to command things. Because when you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will never be sick again. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, God will heal you of everything emotionally, physically, socially, and otherwise. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, everything that you lay your hands to do will begin to fall in place. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, even when you are in the grave, in a grave-shattering situation, God will still come in and bring you forth. Why? Because you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus. The Bible speaking says, when I see the blood, I would pass over you. When I see the blood, I would pass over you. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter how long it's taking. It doesn't matter how long you've stayed in that situation. But today, I have come to tell you that if you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, then you are coming out. Every chain is breaking forth. Everything is laying loose. You shall not remain in bondage. You are not permitted. You are too defended to be attacked. You are too grace-filled to be down. You are too spiritual. You are too dedicated. You are a child of God. So the devil cannot trick you. Enough of the mind game with the devil. You gotta tell yourself, now that I know what God wants me to do with the blood of Jesus, remember that it is the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. So God's last card for escape for you, for me, is for us to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus and begin to make things happen. And begin to make things happen. Like we have read in all the scripture that I gave to you, please make sure that you read it. Please make sure that you read it. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will begin to understand that you have the right to stay in good health, that you have the right to receive healing, that you have the right to be rich, that you have the right to be wealthy, that you have the right to be happy, that you have the right to be settled, that you have the right to have that job. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, you will know that you are entitled to every inheritance as a child of God. When you know the power that is in the blood of Jesus, then you would know that there is nothing that you would speak, that you would command, that God will not bring it to pass for you. Because you're asking it through what? The blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel.
God bless us. God bless us. So right now we are going to be praying and we're going to be telling God that God should break every chain. That God should break every chain and give us the grace to be able to use the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. Just go ahead and pray. God, please, I want you to open my eyes of understanding. As I have heard this word today, Lord, I want you to make me to know how to use the power that is in the blood of Jesus. How to use the power that is in your blood to command my health, to command my money, to command my marriage, to command my children's health, to command my wants, to command my finances, to command my relationship. Everything that you have created me for. Every beautiful thing that you have made for me, I want you to bring it to pass. I want you to bring it to manifest. I want you to bring it to fulfillment. Now, as I will begin to declare the power that is in the blood of Jesus. That is your prayer point. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. God, give me the grace to be able to use the power that is in your blood to get whatever I want in my life. Father, give me the grace to be able to use the power that is in your blood to receive my healing. Give me the power to be able to use the power that is in your blood to command everything that is not working in my life, physically, socially, financially, and otherwise. Give me the grace, Lord, to be able to stand. Give me the grace, Lord, to be able to command, to speak the word, so that I will be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, we worship you, we adore you because there's none like you. We give you the glory, we give you the honor for a beautiful moment in your presence. Father, thank you because you said in your word that we two or three are gathered, that you are there in their midst. Father, today we were more than 10, we were more than 20. We came in assembly. You said that you can never put into rejection the assembly and the gathering of the children of God. Father, today we have heard the word about the power in the blood of Jesus. Father, today that we have heard your word in the power of the blood of Jesus. Let the power that is in your blood heal us. Let the power that is in your blood do not allow the devil to come near us anymore. Let the power that is in your blood be a rescue power for us. Let the power that is in your blood impact us that the devil cannot attack us. Let the power that is in your blood chase the devil and his concubine far away from us. Let the power that is in your blood give us make us so defended that the devil cannot attack us. Let the power that is in your blood, let it be a grave shattering power for us. That even when we are down, that even when we run into accident, Lord, you will rescue us. Let the power that is in your blood, Lord, give us the understanding to our right to good health and healing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. It is well with you. The Lord will give you the power that is in the blood of his name. The Lord will give you the power that is in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will give you the power that is in the blood of Jesus. God bless you all so much. God bless you all so much. I speak into your life that it shall be well with you. I speak into your life that you will do exploits. I speak into your life that the Lord will see you through. I speak into your life that the Lord will elevate you. I speak into your life that grace will abound with you. I speak into your life that the enemy will not triumph over you. I speak into your life that the good Lord will bring you peace, that the good Lord will settle you in every area of your life, now and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Let's share the grace of fellowship together. Now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord, celebrating forever and ever in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you so much for fellowshipping with me. Thank you for tuning in. God bless you so much. Thank you for tuning in. God bless you. God bless you real good. God bless you real good. You guys know that I love you with the love of God. You guys know that I love you so much. Be prayerful. Read your Bible. Wait on the Lord. There's nothing that is too hard for God to do. Until I come your way again tomorrow, remain ever blessed. And you know what? My greatest wish, above all wishes for us all, is that we will meet heaven at last. Don't forget, use 5 seconds of your time, use 5 seconds of your moment, share this video, to touch a life. There are people who are looking for the power that is in the blood of Jesus. Share this video so they can read the scripture. They can hear the word. They can study the word. And God will touch them at the point of their need. As you share this video, may God meet you. Every difficulty, every problem in your life is coming to an end in less than 24 hours. God bless you. And do have a wonderful time. Love you guys so much. I love you guys so much. Remain blessed, sweethearts. Bye.